The recording and reproduction of sounds can be traced all the way back to the invention of the phonograph in 1877. From then on, the methods of recording progressed as more advanced technologies were invented and new discoveries were made. That brings us to today, 135 years later, where we have come up with the perfect logical formula for how to properly record a song in its best light using the latest digital recording technology. In this short video, I'm going to take you through this meticulous process from start to finish in order to give you a better outlook on how the music you listen to was made. The typical recording process can be broken up into three major stages: pre-production, production, and post-production. The first is pre-production, which consists of brainstorming ideas in order to come up with a composition and proper arrangement. Pre-production can be thought of as the most important stage, as it requires the most creativity. During composition, the musician will form ideas for a melody, lyrics, and so on. The recording engineer may throw in some beneficial criticism to help these ideas come into place. During arrangement, the engineer will work with the musician to help determine things such as what instruments to use in the song, what notes or chords they should play, as well as what key it is in, and what tempo would work best. Once all of this is done, and both artists are satisfied, the next stage begins. Production is the stage where recording takes place. This is where things start to get a little technical. When recording a performance, it is best to record in an acoustically tuned, sound-isolated room. The engineer will choose what microphone is best for what is being recorded, and will place it at the correct distance away from its source. After volume levels are tested, it is then up to the musician to give their best performance, which usually takes several attempts. The microphone will capture all sounds and send them in real time to the engineer's computer program, which is known as the Digital Audio Workstation. The musician will almost always be wearing a set of headphones, which will play a metronome beat to help them stay in time while playing their instrument. If vocals are involved, they will usually hear the main chords of the song played through the headphones in order to sing in key. In today's recording programs, there are virtually unlimited tracks or channels that can be controlled separately from other tracks, which will allow the musician or band to record as many parts as they want. Once all tracks are laid down, it is time to go back to the control room for the final stage. During post-production, it is solely up to the engineer to edit, mix, and master the song in order to bring everything together into a polished, radio-ready piece of work. This process takes a great amount of experience and skill from the engineer, and though the musician may not know what's going on part of the time, they are always welcome to observe and critique as the engineer works his magic. During non-destructive editing, which is only possible due to digital and non-linear recording, the recorded tracks can be altered in several different ways, such as adding effects like reverb or delay, changing pitch or tempo, cutting and pasting, and so on. The possibilities of editing are almost infinite with today's technology. During mixing, all recorded and now edited tracks will be meticulously blended in together by altering volume levels and panning tracks from left to right to create a full stereo recording. This step may also include altering the frequencies and gain of a track through EQ, compression, limiting, and more. Once all tracks are brought together, levels sound great, desired effects are achieved, and both the engineer and musician are very pleased with what they hear, it is time to master the track. This simply makes sure the song can be played through any device and still sound great, which requires the engineer to do many things, such as pumping the song to a usable volume, changing the master settings to a desired output, and testing the song out on several devices. This could get really difficult, as mastering a track is considered an art itself. So there you have it, folks. This demonstration may have taken a few minutes, but this process could take days to complete. The recording process is very advanced nowadays, and people tend to overlook exactly how the music they're listening to was made. I hope you've learned something new today, as well as gained respect for both the musician and the recording engineer. At least now, if you ever have a song of your own to record, you'll have a good idea of what you're in for.